Senator Ted Cruz gave Yale students a reality check over the attempts to silence conservatives at their school and campuses all across America.
And I got to tell you, when you come out of school, most places you work are not safe spaces. Most bosses are not going to be overly worried about injuring your fragile feelings. And so I think the point of education is to prepare you for life. And that means encountering things that make you uncomfortable, that make you doubt, that make you question. That's really what an education is all about.
Senator Cruz, along with many others, also signing an open letter demanding that Yale punish the disruptors or the protesters at last month's free speech event.
Author and Rubin Report host Dave Rubin joins us now to react. Dave, what about the senator going back to the eye of the storm with that school of thought, which was remarkably unpopular with the student body?
Well, good for Ted Cruz. And of course, Ted Cruz is completely right here. Look, you have a right to protest. It's the most American right there is. You can voice your opinion and you can do it peacefully and properly. And that's what the free exchange of ideas is all about. What you can't do is use your free speech to shout down somebody else. You can't lock doors. You can't pull fire alarms. The litany of other things that we've seen students do over the last, 5 to 10 years or so. And it's sort of like, at this point, enough is enough. We have let the inmates run the asylum at virtually every college in America. And until the administrators, the professors, the donors, until they all decide this can't happen anymore, it's going to continue to happen. I suspect at this point the institutions are probably too infected and we just need to build new things, because it doesn't seem, no matter how many times you guys talk about it, talk about it, or Ben Shapiro talks about it, they just keep marching. So maybe we just actually need new things.
Well, that's a great point. But the irony of that event we were looking at, where the speakers were shouted down, is it was a free speech event. And they didn't want to hear one side of it. And I think it was about a week after that, then a federal judge suggested, on appeals court, suggested he sent an email out to other judges, and he said, I don't think we should hire clerks from Yale Law School, because I don't know that they can be fair, given the fact that they won't even listen to both sides of a story.
Well, Brian, first off, it's 2022. Irony is long since dead, so there's nothing we can do on the irony factor. But yes, I mean, this is the problem, because it's not just that we're allowing these kids to shout down speakers who are invited by the school. I mean, in Ted Cruz's case, we're talking about a sitting senator, right? It's not just that. It's that then the education that these kids get, the very things they learn, the things that law students should learn related to the exchange of free speech and protest and peaceful protest, they're learning all the wrong things. Then they get out into the real world. And as Ted Cruz said, you get out to the real world, you have a real job, you better be ready for occasionally someone might say something upsetting to you, and it doesn't mean you get to burn down the office you're in or take down the company with you, which seemingly is happening all over the country.
Dave, I'm glad you said burn down, because your book is called Don't Burn This Country, Surviving and Thriving in Our Woke Dystopia, and it's on sale today. It reminds me of what Ronald Reagan said in his inaugural address in 1967, and this is a quote from it. Freedom is a fragile thing, and it's never more than one generation away from extinction. It is not ours by way of inheritance. It must be fought for and defended constantly by each generation, for it comes only once to a people. Tell us about your book.
Man, does that quote ring true now or what? In essence, that very much is what the book is about. You know, we can all mock the woke kids and make fun of them for the gender pronouns, and that suddenly 2 + 2 = 5, and that being non-racist is suddenly racist, and the rest of the stuff. But you have to give the devil his due. That really is what this book is about. They have marched through our cultural institutions, our educational institutions, as we just talked about, our political institutions. They have brought in collectivism, socialism, communism, Marxism, whatever you want to call it, and they are destroying the foundation of America, starting with the foundational documents and the history of America and everything else. This book is really, hey, give them some credit. You may not like what they did, but they've done it. We all know it. Every day another crazy story comes out that we all have to cover. What can you do in the midst of that to not just survive but thrive. There are things like, hey, maybe don't go to college and get $150,000 into debt and then have some job that you don't really like. Maybe learn a trade. Right. There's all sorts of ways. You know, take care of your digital assets so you're not so reliant on big tech. Know what you think and why you think it. These are sort of basic things in some way, but we need them now more than ever because, as I said earlier, these guys are not stopping, and we all know it.
Great ideas, great book. Check it out. You can buy it everywhere, wherever you buy books. It's called Don't Burn This Country. Dave Rubin, thank you very much for joining us today.
Thank you, Dave. Wishing you the best with your book.
Good to be with you guys.
Good to have you.
Thanks.
If you're looking for more honest and thoughtful conversations about politics instead of nonstop yelling, check out our politics playlist. And if you want to watch full interviews on a variety of topics, watch our full episode playlist all right over here. And to get notified of all future videos, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell.